I'm Cassidy Cloninger. I'm 17. I go to Cardinal Gibbons High School, and I'm a senior this year. I'm very busy. I'm varsity swim team. Do some nerdy clubs. I'm an alchemist club. Do some history club. I do surf club, which is the one fun club I have. NHS vice president. That's National Honor Society. It's a academic and community service group that the schools do. We do a lot of stuff with Habitat for Humanity, the food bank in North Carolina, the elderly homes and the nursing care homes. And I'm a debutante on top of all of it. Well, at first I did not want to do it. I didn't know what the deb experience really was. Everybody has this preconceived notion of debs. I'm not into the whole, you know, poofy dress, pretty things. Like, I'm just not that kind of girl. I'm the kind of, like, let's go surfing and listen to rock and roll, and like, I'm not your like princessy girl. I never was growing up. I think it kind of probably did surprise a lot of people because they see me, you know, differently than that.
We wanted a young woman who had been involved in the community, whether it's through church, community activity, school activities, but somebody who made a difference in our community. So we believe in recognizing your talents and your accomplishments at this level in the hopes that it will help promote your philanthropic interest for the future.
When I started out as a historian and decided one of the things I wanted to look at were issues that mattered in the lives of women, one of the obstacles to doing that was the fact that women's lives are often unrecorded. So you can find out best about what women are up to and what their hopes and aspirations are about by looking at the material culture of their lives. It's more interesting to me to find out about the order they impose upon themselves by submitting to this debutante ritual than almost anything else. That's how you find out about women.
Next page is my favorite page. Matters of etiquette. When you get those invitations, and you'll get quite a few, please respond. You know pretty much when you get an invitation if you're going to be able to attend or not. And what happens when you put it aside and say, oh, I'll answer that later? You know, things get piled on it and you forget. So there's nothing wrong with responding the minute you get it. It does not, as a hostess, I can tell you, it does not make it look like you're desperate to go to a party. It just makes it look like, boy, she's got it together and she's really polite. So please do that right away. Thank you notes. You should send that really within the week. They do need to be written in ink, not pencil. And these are skills, I promise y'all, that you will, yeah, when you get married, when you interview for a job, what have you. As my daughter, who just turned 16 yesterday, says, there's a lot of benefit in a good thank you note. And there really is, as moms will tell you.
Well, my first impression of the whole debutante ritual was that it was incredibly mysterious. I mean, why did you, in our modern times, this is after all the 21st century, put on a white dress and dance with your father? I remember thinking it was all just a little silly.
The next thing that's really important for y'all need to go ahead and get your dresses, and you need to figure out who your marshal's going to be. And we call the chief marshal is your dad or stepfather, uncle, cousin, significant adult male in your life. Your marshal is the boy your age. The next page is about your attire. First and foremost, no strapless, because, you know, it doesn't look nice when you're pulling it up. And it's more comfortable if you have straps or something. But they can, a bridal shop can add straps. No trains, because you have to be able to dance. And one thing that Ms. Strasser, who does the choreography, always recommends that you know, when you're trying it on, you raise your arms up and you twirl around and see how comfortable it is. Can you move? Because in those dances, she's got you moving your arms and moving all over the place. Just walk around the shop and take some time. right there.
Okay. Shoes should be white with a 1 to 2 inch heel. The fabric shoes, the dyeable ones.
Exciting.
They should have a closed toe and heel, and you have to wear them to all dance rehearsals. So let's make sure they're comfortable.
That's thrilling. These fit.
Okay. Measure 8.
They fit.
Stand up and walk around them.
They're really cute.
I like them with your jeans.
Thank you. Yeah, that's a hot look. My dad's an optometrist. My mom works in his office occasionally. My brother is 13. He started high school this year with me. He's a freshman. My dad knows a lot of people in this community, and they never came out and said that they wanted me to, but I kind of got the feeling they did, so I felt slightly obligated. But I knew I'd meet a lot of girls that I didn't know simply because I didn't go to school with them or, you know, I'd never met them, so that was a big reason for me to do it. But I knew that my dad was involved with the community, so I kind of needed to get out there a little bit, I guess. I don't know. But mostly just because I wanted to meet new people.
Oh, man, I think we have a winner.
Oh, I never realized there were so many different colors of white. I can't even name how many different colors of white I tried on that are all white, apparently, and all can be the color of a Deb dress. I can't really think of a word to describe it. Long. It took a while to find a dress that I knew nobody else would have, that I actually liked, that my mother liked. It was just a very long process. I definitely went a few days for hours to find the right dress.
Dressing has always been a big part of a debut, and like the wedding gown, its successor. It symbolized a lot about an adolescent girl, about a family's ability to pay. But for the most part, a Deb dress is white, and it stands for purity. I think in the 19th century and up till maybe the 1940s, there was a lot you could hope for after a debut. It was a coming-of-age ritual. You could be your own woman, you could stay out at night, you could walk on the street. All sorts of things that you couldn't do before when you were essentially a child.
This is way harder than I thought it would be.
How's it going?
Dad's here.
Dad!
Yes.
Hi, Daddy.
How are you?
Good. You like it?
Hello. Well, I feel like you're getting married.
No! We've been working really hard to not have a wedding dress.
Very pretty.
Do you like it?
I do.
Here, I'll stand up on a box for you.
Yeah, that'd be great.
I think the dress sets you apart from your everyday activities. Now that we all slop around in jeans for most of the time, the fact that you would have a special dress, boned within an inch of its life, made of an expensive material, I think that's important. You'll remember that dress for a long time.
Okay, I want this one.
What?
I want this one.
What?
Oh, be quiet, I want this one.
These shoes are shipped in the middle. You don't see the shoes.
They're still ugly.
But they're the right color.
Are they?
Yeah, look.
Well, isn't that convenient? And what was the total, I'm sorry?
1846. I'd like to welcome all of you to our first mother's meeting, and I'm delighted that you're here. I'm going to work with each group of you on the party. There will be 5 families to host each party. And some of you may know each other. You may have already talked about, you know, if our girls do this, let's host a party together. If you don't know anybody and you haven't talked to anyone, tonight is the night. We're going to do sign up. Okay? and I'll quickly be in touch with you to set a date for the meeting. The meeting is for the girls and for the moms. The whole idea here is for you to work with your daughters in the planning, developing the concept, and putting this whole party together. It's not just for the moms to get together and decide. Some very important things that you'll read in here about party attendance. If I'm paying the money and I'm giving the party as a parent and my daughter's there as a hostess, it doesn't make me feel very good if Virginia comes in as a Deb and stays an hour and a half and takes off with her boyfriend. It's just not fair. So we expect the girls and their dates, if it's that type of a party, to come at the beginning and stay till the end. Again, this is a training and an educational process for the girls.
But, you know, they are being watched. And people out in the community do know that they're debutantes and will tell us things if they think that there's something that they did that they shouldn't have done. And believe me, we'll hear it. I know that because I have. So any disciplinary action in school, any disciplinary action in the community, or drinking at any debutante event, they will more than likely be dismissed from the debutante experience, and we do not give refunds. So just tell them to be on their best behavior.
Oh, you guys look beautiful.
Ready?
Basically, if there's only a few things that we could tell you today that you always remember is stay out of the sun, protect your eyes, and drink a lot of water.
And don't pop your pimples, please.
I think there was a lot of mixed feelings going into the first party because it was an all-girls party. I think some of us kind of wanted the guys there, sort of a distraction, so we didn't have to sit down and get to know these girls. But it helped everyone to get to know, like, just basic stuff that you learn about people, so it was good to do that without the distraction.
We did the massage strokes. Up, wipe up. So just basically massage it on. The reason why you're wiping up is because you want it to get into the pores to clean them and hydrate them, but you don't want to push any dirt deeper in. So that's why you don't start at your forehead and work down.
Let's go give it! Let's go give it!
Well, Mary Ellen I knew from school, but like if we didn't have Deb, like we would not be good friends now. I can definitely say that because I'm not in any of her classes. I don't do the same sports as her. So there would be no reason for us to like spend time together unless it had been through Deb.
BJ Vaughn on the carry for the Crusaders.
Don't lose your pom-poms.
Goes back to the line of scrimmage.
Crusaders!
Okay, what's going on
tonight?
9:30.
I have Deb pictures for the program. So we get all dressed up to take a 10-minute picture.
When is the ball?
December 28th.
December? Man.
Here, I'll hold all this.
You want this on top?
Underneath.
Yeah.
Will you be able to get it on?
We should have put it on before I tied.
Probably.
You got like 5 people working on you, Kathy.
Yeah. I can't move.
Well, okay. I'm sorry, but I'm like grabbing her off me.
I can't.
I got it. Mom, you gotta get it under this thing.
Okay, hold on.
I'm sorry. Wait.
There we go. Now let's just get
this. We'll put it on.
Don't
get lipstick on this dress.
All right,
let's see.
You
can get lipstick on your dress today.
Maybe a little. No!
I didn't mean to! You flung it up and then you
can't.
No.
Oh, okay.
Just to check
it.
Where is it? Just, you won't be able to see it.
Oh, okay.
They're black and white.
No. Alright, shoes.
Done.
I'm sorry, I got lipstick.
Hang on. Wait. There you go.
Jesse, I don't want to be around you when you get married, okay? It's
just uh-uh.
It won't work. I mean, it won't matter for the...
Maybe back in the 30s and 40s and early 50s, Debs were considered terrible snobs or, you know, rich girls and all that stuff. I think today, it's more that they're considered peculiar. Why would you want to go through all of this anyway when you can just go to a school dance and have all the same experiences except your father isn't going to be there and your mother's not going to be fussing over your zipper?
I can't. That's wrong.
That's what she did.
Was
it five? Our second Deb party is what we are attending tonight, and it's what does the invitation call it? Famous couples?
Famous couples night, yeah.
Yeah. So I'm going as Jessica Simpson, Nick Lachey.
And I'm going as Danny and Sandy from Greece.
I mean, that was kind of another awkward party, but they had food to distract us, so that was good. 8th grade dance, like, we like people, but we don't want to be near them quite yet. So I think if that type of party had been at, say, like the last party, we would have been a lot more like used to each other and we all would have been dancing. So I think that was just an awkward party because of its timing, not necessarily because of the way it was planned or the nature of the party. It was just timing was off.
Are you all wearing name tags that have the name that you're called?
Yes.
Okay, good. And just help me, bear with me for a while until I can learn who you are. You may call me Teresa. You don't have to call me Mrs. Strasser.
All right, Miss Teresa is going to teach you the curtsy, the bow, when you make your presentation. And there is a way to do this so that you don't do a dive off of the steps. And so we're going to teach you that today. And then as soon as the dads have finished with their tuxedo measurements, we'll bring them in and we're going to start basic dance steps for the father-daughter dance.
Present, open, curtsy down, lift, feet together.
Forward, open. Dancing, I have two left feet, so that's going to be the most difficult part, learning all those waltzes and stuff. And hopefully I won't fall on my face coming down the stairs after I'm presented. That's the number one thing I'm hoping for. But, you know, getting through the dances will be good, too.
It's beautiful. Are you good? Hi, Beth. Okay, if you stand with your daughter, that would be terrific.
Stand with your daughter right now so you can just see the change of way.
Left, right, left. Right, left, right. One, two.
It was so funny because, I mean, he doesn't dance either, so it was kind of good to have somebody else going through it with me that was just as bad. So I wasn't in it alone, but I mean, my dad and I have always been pretty close, so it's not like one of those relationships where it's like, oh, we have to spend time together. Like, it was just like another thing we did, so it was fun.
The origin of making a debut is, I think, lost in history. There are as many explanations for this as there are explainers. One important element was the presentation of a suitable young woman ready for marriage to the court in England. That kind of thing has been going on for generations, and it came to a kind of head during the reign of Queen Victoria. But that was a certification that your daughter was respectable, that your family did not consist of cads and bounders, as the 19th century so beautifully phrased it, and that all was well then for a girl to go about the vigorous pursuit of a husband.
Each of the girls has a Christmas tree at the Deb Ball, and so at each party, a Christmas ornament is given to symbolize your party. So these are decorated in a casino theme.
We'll roll one more time, then we'll catch you in.
Hey, we probably shouldn't have picked some so close to each other.
It's okay.
That's true.
Our party was just easy to like talk to people and still have something to do.
33
black.
I won like twice. So the casino aspect of it, you know, it gave people a chance to like talk to people next to them, but not have to actually get into a conversation, and they could just have fun.
That's like the good thing I didn't pull that. Oh my god, I would have lost in the full house.
Well, up front, the fee is $1,600. And a lot of people say, why in the world would you pay $1,600 for your daughter to go to a bunch of parties? And I don't see it as paying for her to go to a bunch of parties. I think there are a lot of social benefits that she can experience and gain knowledge of that will carry her through the rest of her life.
Double side right. One, two. All right, let's do three box steps. Turn her underneath, reconnect. Ready?
Okay, yeah.
Ready?
Mm-hmm. I'm ready for this.
And, wait a minute. Girls back to that window wall. You have to move. The girls will show you. Ready, girls? Go. Turn.
Wade is such a personality that like he just goes with the flow on everything. Like he made me laugh so hard during those rehearsals. I can't really picture anybody else going through that experience with me.
The reason why young men serve as escorts to Debs, I think, has a lot to do with their mothers. I think their mom suggests that it might be nice to be a civilized young gentleman now and again, and how splendid they look in their black coats. So I think there's a little bit of family pressure involved.
I don't want to brag. We were the best group here.
No, we were not. I think it went well. He didn't step on my feet, so that was good.
Not once.
Not once.
From the top.
Having a debut somehow confers distinction not only on the young women and their families, but also on the city. Many small communities are attempting to assert their right to social equality with old money enterprises in big cities by holding community debuts.
Up until probably the mid-1970s, Cary was a very small town, less than 12,000 people. However, in the 70s, when Research Triangle Park started to come online and companies began moving people here from all over and populating their jobs out in the park, they needed a place to live. And as a result, Cary grew by leaps and bounds throughout the 70s, 80s, and 90s. Today, we're in excess of 100,000 people in Cary.
Don't get so
think that the reason that the Cary Debutante Society was formed was a very simple reason. It goes back to old Southern tradition that to be a debutante, it depended on what your parents did in life, what your grandparents did in life, and maybe even their parents. Well, was that fair? We didn't think so. So we wanted to kind of change that and recognize the young women for what they had accomplished, not what parents, grandparents had accomplished.
You don't get a lot of girls who are snobby because there are these rich girls who are just supposed to be in deb. You know, they're like assumed that they're going to be in deb. It's, you know, good girls who are just like there to have fun and meet new people.
You want to go? You want to go with us? Come on, get in the car. Come on, go get in the car.
Load up.
Get in there, hop up.
Jump, jump, jump. It's going to be, you got to jump hard. There you go.
We will see you there.
Excited to see what Cassie and her dad have learned in the dance lessons. I think it's going to be sort of bittersweet to see her because this is her senior year and she will be leaving. And this is probably one of the last big things that we're going to all do together before graduation. So I'm trying not to get choked up about it. I didn't realize I was that sensitive about it, but I'm really looking forward to it because she is very special to me and we do have a very special relationship and she is very appreciative of the opportunity to do this. And so I'm looking forward to seeing her shine that night.
I guess I think now that it's kind of touching and interesting that we should preserve a ritual that after all has to do with, among other things, the protection of women, the assertion of familial values, status of a family, that we should preserve a ritual like this for 300 years or plus in America and still derive some incredible pleasure from it, despite all its anxieties.
Yeah, over a couple more inches. Yeah, there we go.
When I started working on debutantes, I assumed that this was a very important Southern ritual. But I'm no longer sure of that. The Midwest was a very important debutante spot. And I refer to the important debutante balls in St. Louis and in Kansas City. There are still important cotillions in Philadelphia, New York, Boston. But in reality, I think it's fairly evenly spread around nowadays.
The way I understood it is it's supposed to depict the girl's life. So what we did is we took some of Cassidy's favorite pictures and then we had ornaments for what depicts Cassidy's life, especially high school life.
That's like my favorite ornament.
Is it?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Take your time. Plant your toe back there. Hurts. Beautiful. Beautiful. Much better. Okay. Whoa, 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 go back. She's quick. Wait for dad.
When you walk out, it'd be great if you really looked at your mother and smiled big, okay? Try not to look down, try not to look at the ceiling. Look at your mom or the whole row. Do your curtsy, walk to here, look at your dad. He's somebody very special in your life. He's put a lot of hard work into this. He looks great. So dad comes out and you're looking at him, big smile. Dad, get close enough to her. Your purpose is to help her down the steps. Don't make her do this. And it's also, again, for safety reasons. I don't want her to, believe me, we see a trip or a slip almost every year.
Oh, so good. God.
Yeah. Right. Then come down, you're still looking at dad. Blink eye.
here comes Honey Bun over here, cutie pie. You take your bouquet from him, your little eye contact there, look back at Dad. Now, dads and daughters, you can talk to each other if you want to right now, whatever you need to do to make each other feel comfortable, because it's kind of scary. These lights are all down, you're in the spotlight, it's hard to see. So, you know, talk, if you got some little nickname for each other, you know, do something that makes each other really smile. Come here, slowly walk around. Dad, you can move. You don't need to stand there like, you know, you
a toy
can
soldier.
Move. Yeah, like a toy soldier. Girls, eye contact again. Okay. He's going to let go. He's going to stop. The girl probably won't even remember because she's going to be got so many things in her mind. So, dads, help remember to stop. Let her go. She's going to go over. Girls, please hug and kiss your mom. 1 year, I had a girl that did not do it. She was the only one, and her mother was devastated. So, please kiss her. Hug her. I don't care. Whatever else you want to do is up to you, but just make sure you do that.
Hey, Mom.
Hey, Mom, how you doing?
And then hook up.
And then have no violence.
The next time you do it, which will not be tonight, I want you to give me a little bit of showmanship, you know, a little bit of stage presence.
Posture. Good posture.
You are on the stage, and people are looking at you from three sides. So remember that. Stay in. I hate to use this word, but stay in character. And you are the Cinderella, so walk and carry yourself that way, which you do anyway. Get your heels off the floor. That's making that
dance. That's the waltz.
So it's down, up, and up. Okay, ready, go. Down, up, up, down, up.
Elegance is a part of this whole thing in that the ultimate test of a young woman used to be her ability to walk across a ballroom. Would she slouch? Would she, heaven forbid, trip and fall? Would she falter because eyes were upon her as they had never been before? All of these material symbols are ways of reinforcing this fundamental sense of rules, whether it's where you pick up your fork or how you comport yourself in a public place.
I'm ready for Deb to be over. I'm so ready for it to be done. It's just so time consuming and stressful. I mean, it's been fun like meeting everybody and like getting dressed up for the parties and stuff, but I never in my life cared to learn how to waltz.
Your French twist's got a dip in here just because it's so straight.
Uh-huh.
So what I'm thinking is coming through here,
mm-hmm,
and then doing a really big curl.
Yeah.
Just for something different.
Fine with me?
And it's still, it's so elegant.
Yeah, no, it looks good.
Is that good?
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna, yeah,
because... still be,
yeah.
I had so much makeup on because they tell you when the spotlight comes on you, it completely washes you out. So if you don't have, like, three times as much makeup on as you normally do, then, you know, you don't even see your face.
Yay. You like it?
I do. See, I told you she's not. Fine.
Oh, it's perfect.
Do you like it?
I love it.
Good. So I'm glad. Thank you.
Oh, you know what? That's just perfect.
Do you think I can hide my lip gloss in my top, too?
That's where I was putting mine.
Can you tell it's there?
Yeah.
Cool. That's okay. Does it fall out?
No, but I laughed and mine just moved down.
I don't think it's going anywhere.
Alright.
Let's go.
Okay. Wade's a great guy. He's one of those kids that we've known since kindergarten. You know, Cassidy came home from kindergarten and said, I found my three new best friends. And Wade was one of those friends. So I think that's a great choice.
The girls start with their photography sessions about 2 in the afternoon. And to see everybody all dressed, the hair done, it's like the total transformation. It really is emotional when you've spent the months getting to know the families. And then you see them there with the dads with the arms around the daughters, and the moms are just standing there smiling, and grandparents all dressed up, not ever having a daughter, not ever having been a debutante. it just fulfills something in me that just makes me feel so happy and so proud to have been a part of providing this experience for these girls and its families. This is silly. You can tell I believe in what I do.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. Everybody blow me a kiss.
That's right. Scattered bird.
All right. This is our big night. Our big night. Girls, it's your Cinderella moment. I do want you to smile and have fun, and dads, just remember this moment while you're dancing. Don't worry if you got every little step. Just do the best you can, and it will be very joyful if you'll look at it that way and not worry about it so much. Marshals, do what you've done so well all along. Now, don't let me down. Don't decide not to do a great job tonight. Do a really good job. And what are our famous initials? ESS?
Eyes up, shoulders back, smile, smile, smile.
Okay, is everybody okay tonight? Have any issues? Everybody well?
I'm just gonna stuff everything I can put in my face.
You should have eaten before you put your dress on, you'd be fine.
Brush step, touch step, touch step, touch box step. 1, 2, 3, 4. Side and linear, and beautifully smile at your dad. Linear, and 3, 2, and then pull back. 1, 2,
where's the skirt?
Last time, and 1, 2, and okay, ready? Go. Up, out, down, lift, and relax. Good.
Good evening, Merry Christmas, and welcome to the 10th Cary Debutante Ball. My name is Angela Hampton. I am the 6 and 11 o'clock anchor at ABC 11 Eyewitness News, and I am delighted to be with you for the 6th year in a row as your mistress of ceremonies for this evening's event. Thank you. To begin our evening, before we bring the debutantes out for you to see them, we would like to introduce to you the Cary Debutante Ball Society Chairwoman, Mrs. Sandy Cohn Kennedy Maybaum, escorted by Mr. Bobby Maybaum.
All right, let's bow our heads. Heavenly Father, bless these beautiful young women. Give them the strength and the confidence and the pure joy for their Cinderella night tonight.
It's not only for the girl, but for the entire family. It makes us a little bit sad sometimes when we see that father-daughter dance and you look over at the moms and they've got little tears in their eyes, and the brothers who come out as marshals and the grandparents, aunt and uncles. It's just an amazing family experience.
We need your help. We trust in you, and bless us all. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Good luck, girls.
All right, ladies. Good luck.
Y'all stay here. Okay. I'm going to come and tell you when to go to your back stools. It's going to be about 2 or 3 minutes.
And I thank you so much for your faith and trust in me, and look forward to being a part of this for many years to come. Thank you all for being here. Enjoy your evening.
Do you guys remember the first party we had and how we were split into two tables and how nobody would talk at all?
How awkward.
Do you remember how awkward that was? Yeah.
That was like so weird. What?
All right, our program continues now as we present those special people who have played such an important role in the lives of our debutantes, the mothers of the 2007 debutantes escorted by the marshals.
Thank you.
women for their outstanding achievements of leadership in their schools, their communities, and their churches. We are very excited about this. Centuries ago, women were debuted to show off the most marriageable young lady.
Tonight, we wish to present these young ladies who will be our future. They will become the corporate leaders, the community volunteers, our social conscience.
And perhaps they will raise families who will hold the values of solutions represented here tonight. Indeed, they will influence the world and what it is to become.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Cary Debutante Ball Society proudly presents the 2007 Debutantes. Miss Ashley Lauren Bennett. Miss Stephanie Michelle Bernath. Miss Kara Donna Buckless.
Kara is the daughter of Dr. Frank Allen Buckless and Miss Donna Kara Buckless.
Miss Grace Holloway Burton.
Don't look down.
Okay.
All right. I'll be
like this.
Yeah. Don't look down.
Miss Mary Ellen Ashton Kane. Mary Ellen is the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Philip Kane. She is the stepdaughter of Mr. Roy Mashburn. Her chief marshal is Roy Evans Mashburn Jr. Her marshal is Jonathan Michael Anthony Bassey.
Mary Ellen attends Cardinal Gibbons High School, where she's a member of the cheerleading squad. She's enjoyed coaching the St. Michael's Middle School cheerleading team, and she was greatly affected by working on the National Honor Society Christmas Toy Drive, where she felt the true meaning of Christmas with young children. She hopes to major in criminal justice with a minor in forensic science at Western Carolina University. Miss Mary Ellen Ashton.
Miss Cassidy Ann Cloniger. Cassidy is the daughter of Dr. and Mrs. Donovan Raul Cloniger, Jr. Her chief marshal is Dr. Donovan Cloniger. Her junior marshal is Connor Gray Cloniger. Her marshal is Wade Connolly Snedeker. Cassidy attends Cardinal Gibbons High School, where she is captain of the varsity swimming team. She's vice president of the National Honor Society and has participated in Teen Corp. Her favorite philanthropic project was Habitat for Humanity. She represented the Cary McGregor Rotary Club at the North Carolina Rotary Youth Leadership Conference this year and has been invited back as a counselor.
She hopes to major in communications in the advertising field.
Miss Cassidy Ann Cloniger. Miss Julie Florence Cooper.
I didn't fall, that was good.
Still standing.
Did you mess up? Good.
Miss Annabeth Lofton. Miss Courtney Elise Merritt.
Nailed that thing. Perfect handoff. Good. Oh yeah, that was fun. And now I get to sit down and do nothing. The rest of the night is going to be amazing.
Me next. I'm not kidding.
How was it?
It was okay.
Did you mess up?
No, I did good.
That's good.
Miss Amanda Nicole Walker. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2007 Cary Debutantes, aren't they beautiful?
What would a ball be without dancing, right? Tonight is what we like to call a Cinderella moment for our beautiful young ladies. Dances with young girls weaving garlands into intricate patterns have been a tradition for centuries. Tonight we would like to present our version of this beautiful dance. Ladies and gentlemen, the Garland Waltz.
In a way, all this ritual pattern making asserts a sense of order. And order is a key to the whole debutante ritual. There's an order to society, there's an order to families, there's an order to when you're supposed to meet the young man, when you're supposed to get married. The world has an order and a structure, and that's what's reinforced by dancing in patterns.
And it's not every day you get to see something like that. Now, I hope you have tissues handy. Did anybody warn you about this? Because the next part does get a little bit emotional, but it is lovely as well. It's not often that dads and daughters get to dance together these days.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are very proud to present the traditional father-daughter waltz.
I think most mothers feel the same way that mothers of the bride feel. The little bud has opened up. The flower is about to emerge. She's independent. So you cry.
My hope was that she would be the type of girl who would exemplify the requirements the Cary Debutante Society upholds. That she would strive to be that kind of person, not just that I would want her to be that kind of person.
Gentlemen, the Marshall's Promenade.
Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop.
You know, I look through that program and just go, wow. Because you see these girls emerge during the year. You know, it was a great experience. Gave her lots of self-confidence. And the closeness that the family gets through that whole process is something that's real special before these girls prepare to go off to college.
It was a great experience. I'm really glad I chose to do it. I don't think any of the girls regretted doing it. You know, it's a big time commitment, a big money commitment, but I mean, I met girls too. I'm going to college with next year, so be friends for life, hopefully.
Casty, I'm glad we did it.
Would you ever be a marshal again?
Depends.
Well, Casty can't be a band man, so.
Yeah, that's why. I'm one and only. Yeah.
We were finally done, so we got to like relax, and I mean, we had these gorgeous gowns on, we had our hair done, we had our makeup done, so it's time to party.
Come on.
Take a ride with me, my dream, in the flow of a cozy B.O.I. Say it loud, girls.